Spirit. Amen. Grace, mercy, and peace of God, our Father, and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you. Please sit down just for a moment. Welcome to all of you here, beginning of half term. The chill, I think, has been taken off the building slightly, because I was able to get the heating back on, thanks to Steve Millwood, who installed a new part. I went down and played with the thermostat without blowing myself and the church up. There is still another notch on the thermostat to go, but when we use a central heating unit, it really is like burning £5 minutes, so we've been as economic as possible whilst trying to make it as safe as possible. Today is Bible Sunday, and it's also the service within which, or just after which, we will have our annual parochial church meeting, which is a legal requirement deferred from the spring. This is because, believe it or not, the Parochial Church Council of Newton Heath is a charitable body that exists for the purposes of the furtherance of religion. And with any body like that, there needs to be an annual meeting to provide a summary of the previous calendar year. It won't detain you very long. All of you should have seen copies of reports, which this might sound a bit bossy. They're not discussion documents, they are precisely that, they are reports. And there are opportunities for you to ask questions if you've not been able to contact me in advance of the meeting via email or by phone. So that's to say, as many AGMs, it's something of a normality. However, we will be electing a new church warden, a deputy church warden, and some people to the Parochial Church Council for the first time, as well as a couple of other church officers. That's the business out of the way. We'll have half a moment's quiet as we remember in God's presence, not at a board meeting, and we'll say our prayer or preparation. We say together, Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, Jesus Christ, to save us from our sins, to be our advocate in heaven, and to bring us to eternal life. Let us confess our sins in penitence and faith, firmly resolved to keep God's commandments and to live in love and peace with all. We say the first prayer of confession. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against our neighbour in thought and word and deed, through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We are truly sorry and repent of all our sins. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you. Pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord. As we're able, we stand to recite the Gloria in Excelsis together. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Blessed Lord, you cause all holy scriptures to be written for our learning. Help us so to give, to read, mark, learn, and inwardly digest them, that through patience and the comfort of your holy word, we may embrace and forever hold fast the hope of everlasting life, which you have given us in our Saviour Jesus Christ, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Please be seated for the Old Testament lesson. A reading from the book of the prophet Nehemiah, the 8th chapter, beginning at the 1st verse. All the people gathered together into the square before the water gate. They told the scribe Ezra to bring the book of the law of Moses, which the Lord had given to Israel. Accordingly, the priest Ezra brought the law before the assembly, both men and women, and all who could hear with understanding. This was on the first day of the 7th month. He read from it, facing the square before the water gate, from early morning until midday, in the presence of the men and the women who could understand, and the ears of all the people were attentive to the book of the law. The scribe Ezra stood on a wooden platform that had been made for the purpose. They read from the book from the law of God with interpretation. They gave the sense so that the people understood the reading. And Nehemiah, who was the governor, and Ezra the priest and the scribe, and the Levites, who taught the people, said to all the people, "This day is holy to the Lord your God. Do not mourn or weep." For all the people wept when they heard the words of the Lord. Then he said to them, "Go your way, eat the fat and drink sweet wine, and send portions of them to those for whom nothing is prepared. For this day is holy to our Lord, and do not be grieved, for the joy of the Lord is your strength." So the Levites stilled all the people, saying, "Be quiet, for this day is holy. Do not be grieved." And all the people went their way to eat and drink, and to set portions, and to make great rejoicing, because they had understood the words that were declared to them. This is the word of the Lord. As you're able, please stand for the gospel reading. Alleluia, alleluia. Blessed are those who hear the word of the Lord and keep it. Alleluia. The Lord be with you. Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Matthew. Then the sign of the Son of Man will appear in heaven. And then all the tribes of the earth will mourn, and they will see the Son of Man coming on the clouds of heaven with power and great glory. And he will send out his angels with a loud trumpet call, and they will gather his elect from the four winds, from one end of heaven to the other. From the fig tree learn its lesson. As soon as its branch becomes tender and puts forth its leaves, you know that summer is near. And also, when you see all these things, you know that he is near, at the very gates. Truly I tell you, this generation will not pass away until all these things have taken place. Heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will not pass away. This is the gospel of the Lord. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Be seated. Bible Sunday. I hope that some of you, maybe all of you, have remembered to bring along a Bible, which a little bit later in the service will be able to hold up, and we will bless and dedicate for another year's use. I hope you will have read the little message at the beginning of the pew sheet, where I talk about a time team approach to reading scripture. Treat scripture like an archaeological site, which when you visit an archaeological site may not mean very much to you at first, particularly if it's just been uncovered. But because of archaeologists' knowledge of our history and what was going on at the time, they can analyse all the layers of the soil, they can work out approximately the age of some of the things that they find in it. And this is sort of pretty much true of scripture as well. And I hold up my hands here as one guilty as the rest. I don't think the Church of England particularly has been very good about encouraging people to engage with scripture in a way outside church that's not just hearing the comfort of the familiar delivered from a lectern, delivered from an altar platform like this. We nod sagely because these are, as we've been taught, the words of the Lord. And we're not perhaps particularly bothered that they might not make much sense, particularly in some old translations, say of St. Paul's rather more het-up moments in his letters, and often interminable bits from the Old Testament. This is fairly clear. And I think it's really important not just to accept this document as something that was sort of miraculously written down by divine dictation by God, with people faithfully with their quills scratching on parchment. These documents were written because they are vocational documents, because the people were inspired to write them. But they were distilled over many, many generations. The Old Testament has lots of different versions, particularly in the first few books of the Old Testament that we call the Law, the Torah, which was alluded to in the reading from Nehemiah. The ancient mind worked differently from ours, and they wouldn't scratch out an earlier version. They put another version alongside it. And furthermore, it's very nice, is it not, that our prophecies in our version of the Old Testament neatly segue into the early years of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ in his nativity and birth. Well, the Hebrew Bible is arranged in a different order. So those prophecies are in the middle, and they end with the historical documents, the historical books that we call the Old Testament. It begins with the Law, books like Exodus and Genesis and Leviticus, those sorts of things. The Law, Leviticus, hence the reference here to the Levites, who devised a Levitical code for the Jews to behave by. And there are some clues, aren't there, as to how we should treat Scripture actually many, many centuries before Christ. Because it says here that those who were reading these scriptures made sure that people could understand that there was interpretation. At that time, as is the case for some people still in that part of the world, the language is Aramaic and not Hebrew. So there was a degree of translation and interpretation so that the scriptures were made accessible to the people that were listening to them. When I was a kid, we had the authorised version of the Bible and then the New English Bible for a bit, which caused a lot of tutting and sucking of teeth because people seemed to believe that our Bible was delivered to us in perfect 17th century English. And so when people used to say, well, I prefer the original version, when I got a bit sort of older and a bit more cocky, some people here note, I said, well, fine, let's have it in Hebrew and Greek and see how far. Because the scriptures were written not in English, but in Hebrew and in Greek by and large. Most of the Old Testament was written in Hebrew. So we need to engage with these scriptures to try to discover what these things would have meant for people at the time. The people in the reading from Nehemiah were celebrating the completion of a new wall around Jerusalem. The previous one having been bashed down, perhaps as a result of Israel's lack of fidelity with Jehovah. And again, we have in the New Testament reading, even later now in Matthew's narrative, another example of that literature that describes things at the end of time. Does anybody remember what that word was? Not that I'm thinking of any young man in particular. When you're describing things that are happening at the end of time, the genre of literature is called eschatological. Eschatological. So if you don't know what that word means, it's not the end of the world, but actually it is. So we have types of literature here that are used by writers to evoke strongly the imagination. So you have law. you have history, you have prophecy, you have poetry, all contained in this remarkable book that we call the Holy Bible. And we bless God who caused all scriptures to be written for our learning, and so help us to hear them, to read, mark, learn, and inwardly digest them. Because the Bible is not to be feared, the Bible is your friend, because the Bible is written by people just like you and me, but without the benefits or the curse of spell check. Thanks be to God. Amen. Stand to affirm your faith in the words of the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, God and not made, of our being the Father, through him all things were made. For us and our salvation, came down from heaven, was incarnate from the Holy Spirit of the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified by Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures, and ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have an end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, through the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. We acknowledge our baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We hope for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the power of the Spirit, and in union with Christ, let us pray to the Father, who sit on the altar. We pray for the Church throughout the world. States, for their presiding bishop, the Most Reverend Michael Curry. The Pauvoo Communion of Churches, we pray today for the Church of Sweden and the Diocese of Leipzig. Apologies, we should have prayed for the Church in Wales and the Diocese of Carlisle and the Diocese of Stavanger, the Church in Norway. We pray for our bishops David, Mark, and Mark, for the work of this benefice of meeting people, saints. We pray that may God make blessed on this day and guide us in the fulfillment of our duty of service to the people of this place, whom we are required to care for, whose pure of souls rests within our parish boundary. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for the world. We pray for peace with justice. And we pray especially today for the state of Nigeria, following violence, unrest on the streets of Lagos. Mindful of the roots of many of our friends here in that land. We pray for our Queen and her government, all those who are administrating and legislating for the current pandemic, all those who are aggrieved by it, all those whose quality of life and standard of living are further diminished as this pandemic begins another grip in its cycle. We pray for discipline and fellow feeling in our day-to-day doings, that we may be safe and enable the safety of others. Lord, in your mercy, we pray for some rest and refreshment for our schools and all involved with them. We pray that children in those most needy families don't go hungry through this half-term holiday. We thank God for the courage of Marcus Rashford in bringing into high prominence the scandal of children going hungry in this, the sixth wealthiest nation on our planet. So we pray for All Saints, Wilfrid's Briscoe Lane Academy, Christ the King, Co-op Academy Broadhurst, Oldham Bluecoat School, Trinity High School, Hopwood Hall College, and St Ambrose College. Lord, in your mercy. Within the parish, we pray with and for residents of Haringey Road, Heathfield Street, Herondale Close, Heathorn Street, High Peak Street, and Highland Walk. We pray that these streets may be safe. And we pray as before we care for one another as we are commanded to do. Lord, in your mercy. We pray for those seeking alleviation of things that trouble them in mind, body, or spirit, whether they are at home or in hospital. And we pray for all those who care for them. We pray that our hospitals will not be overwhelmed. We give thanks with Andrea for some good news for her as she continues to come to terms with her condition, as she continues to self-isolate at home. We give thanks for Dennis's return home and for his cheerful appearance. And we just hold in our hearts any known to us who are in any need, and we hold before God those things that bug us and prevent a translucent relationship with our Father in heaven. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We give thanks to God for the lives of those who have gone before us in the faith of Christ, thanking God for all that was good in their lives and for all the memories we treasure today. Among those whose anniversaries occur at or around this time, we name Alice Crompton, Alexander Davis, James Beswick, Harold Taylor, Margaret Price, Robin Hemingway, Heskett, Mary Lancashire, Mae Gosling, Margaret Saville, and Dinah Jarvis. Rest eternal grant unto them, O Lord, and let light perpetual shine upon them. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ. For those of you watching at home, I hope you'll be able to join us in your own way to celebrate the peace. And if you're alone, you may be assured of our very warm wishes to you. And those who are here, please, as you're able to stand as we share the peace. Christ is our peace. He has reconciled us to God by his body on the cross. We meet in his name and we share his peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you. In our usual COVID compliant way, let's offer one another a sign of God's peace. Peace be with you. Peace be with you. Present, Lord Jesus Christ, our risen high priest, and make yourself known in the breaking of bread. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Father, we give you thanks and praise for your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your living Word, through whom you have created all things, who was sent by you in your great goodness to be our Saviour. By the power of the Holy Spirit he took flesh. As your Son, born of the Blessed Virgin, he lived on earth and went about among us. He opened wide his arms for us on the cross. He put an end to death by dying for us and revealed the resurrection by rising to new life. So he fulfilled your will and won for you a holy people. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we proclaim your great and glorious name, forever praising you and saying, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. We sit or kneel as we recall the words of the institution. Lord, you are holy indeed, the source of all holiness. Grant that by the power of your Holy Spirit, and according to your holy will, these gifts of bread and wine may be to us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, who, in the same night that he was betrayed, took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the same way, after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me. Great is the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ has risen. Christ will come again. And so, Father, calling to mind his death on the cross, his perfect sacrifice made once for the sins of the whole world, rejoicing in his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, and looking for his coming in glory, we celebrate this memorial of our redemption. As we offer you this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, we bring before you this bread and this cup, and we thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. Send the Holy Spirit on your people, and gather into one in your kingdom all who share this one bread and one cup, so that we, in the company of the Blessed Virgin Mary, St. Wilfrid, St. Anne, St. Cuthbert, and all the saints, may praise and glorify you forever, through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory be yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. Let us pray with confidence as our Saviour has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. We break this bread to share the body of Christ. Jesus, Lamb of God, have mercy on us.
Jesus, bearer of our sins.
Jesus is the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those who are called to his Son. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and I shall be healed. Lord, bless you, that you make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. Lift up your eyes and smile unto you and be in peace. Lord, bless you, that you make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. Lift up the light of his countenance upon you and be in peace. Lord, if Christ keep you eternal, Body of Christ in eternal.
bless you. Let his face to shine upon you. Let his heart to know the light of his name.
Thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him we offer you our souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Send us out in the power of your Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory. Amen. Thank you. As you noticed, the service was a little bit truncated today, and I think what I'm going to do now is we will go ahead with blessing Bibles and blessing our Bible again. And then those of you who absolutely have to go, particularly younger people who are not chaperoned, please leave. But I would like as many as possible, please, just very briefly, to remain behind for our annual parochial meeting. I was going to hold a meeting now between the prayers and the blessing, which would sort of track you. That did seem rather unfair. So those who are watching at home will be finishing the service shortly, but our work will continue with our annual parochial meeting, the details of which you will be spared, and we look forward to your joining us next week for our Patronum Festival, the feast day of All Saints. So I'll save the notices for after the blessing, dismissal and hymn. If I could ask you, those of you with your Bibles, please to have them in your hands. I can't physically touch them. And we'll have a blessing for our Bibles, even there at home, and then we'll have a final blessing and our final hymn, and I'll come back and we will get through the annual program meeting in double quick time. Thank you. So please do stand for the double blessing. And if you have them, your Bibles and your hands. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the gift of your living word, our Bible. We thank you for your divine inspiration, for those who codified your word into written form, for those of us who read it and interpret it. May it always be our friend in time of need, and forever the richest repository of human and divine wisdom. We ask you to bless these sacred books in the name of the Father and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. And the peace of God that passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God, and of his Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit rest upon you this day and evermore. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.